Hello out there. My name is Milesy and welcome to my channel. I'm still a little bit crispy. The fan is still on. It's still last week. We're doing this all at once just so I can put things away, which as you can see, I'm still struggling to do. But there are some shelves coming later this week that will help me find homes for all of that. But let's actually just reach behind us into the magic bag of everything, and we've got another one of those pencil cases, and this is the same deal as the squirrels. I don't like it. I don't like touching that. It's super cute. It feels super sturdy, but it's got that just really awful vinyl texture to it. The inside isn't as bad. I can touch the inside just fine, but the outside is just, ugh, no, don't like it. So that's going to be an interesting one to try to, review if I don't like touching it, but I do like them. They do feel really sturdy. It's super cute. I just don't like touching it. That is the only problem. I don't like touching it. I don't know. Ugh, just don't like it. Don't really have anything else to say about those. It's hard to really take a good look at it if I can't touch it. So let's pull something else out. We have got also some 26 gauge beading wire. I believe it was 26. 24. It said 26 on the listing. Ooh, okay. Listing said 24. Or listing said 26. That says 24. Let's pull one off and see how it is. Yeah, that's definitely 24. That is definitely, oof, definitely 24. Which means I don't think I can use it for anything I had intended to use it for. Well then, okay. I've got some of the Kickstarter beads coming in once I fill out the orders for everyone. I might try to play with some of the Delicas that have come in just to see if I can get this to work with those, because I had some plans for it. I really like the colors. It feels nice and sturdy. It does have some crimping, at least this one does. But they're really nice colors. There isn't, oh, it's way over here. Okay, so there is a little notch where you can just say, eh, go in there maybe. Nope, doesn't seem to want to. But we have how many colors? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 colors. Yep. And we've got red, we've got black, we've got this kind of brown, kind of a pink. Looks like kind of a dark purple. We've got a gold. We've got a really nice, ugh, really nice violet. There we go. And then we've got green, another kind of a bronzy brown, and some really nice blue. So those are nice. I was expecting 26 gauge. If they were 26 gauge, I might have just been able to make it work, but 24 is unfortunately a little too big. It's a little too big, unfortunately, so I'm not sure if I will actually be able to use them. They feel nice and moldable. They're nice and soft. I don't have too much of a problem with that. I'm just not sure now. That one's got, don't know if you can see this, a nice big crimp in it. But I guess that's unfortunate. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with them now, unfortunately, because my plans for them have kind of been upset. Okay, so what is this? I think this might be pencils. And this I can touch. This, it's a nice rough texture, but like it doesn't turn my ears to ash whenever I rub it the wrong way, which is nice. Where's the zipper? It's up here. And yeah, like here we go. What comes in it? Oh, I've needed one of these for a while. I had one and it broke. So this is a pencil extender if you've never seen it. So when your pencil gets down to a little nub, you can put it in there, tighten it, and there you go. I'm looking at this and these numbers, this entire style looks very similar to a set I got for myself a while ago. We have some sketch pencils over here, which are a little harder to see. We've got one graphite pencil, three charcoal, some blenders. I never use these. A blender sharpener, never really use that. An eraser, and then the sharpener, it's for the pencils. Oh, we've got, it's double-ended. I just noticed that. That's cool. It is double-ended. And then we've got, I forgot how many pencils already. A lot. It's a cute case. I like how it folds out this way. I wasn't expecting that. And then it's got a handle here. No, it's a really cute case. I've been wanting to get into pencils. I've got a whole bunch of Prismacolor pencils. The problem is that they're Prismacolor pencils. Prismacolor used to have really nice pencils, and they don't anymore. They just, I don't know. They got bought out by someone else, and their markers have pretty much stayed on par for the same quality. The pencils did not. The pencils really became like Crayola level, so I've been trying to get some other harder pencils and trying to remember how to use them because I haven't used pencils in over a decade, so it's, I've got a couple of pretty decent sets, so hopefully we can start getting back into that again. And then I have another paint set, and this is an acrylic paint set. You'll see that I only pretty much get acrylics and watercolors. I haven't even seen oils come up. If I do, it's not going to be something that I grab, though. I don't like oil paints. That's the one I already know I don't like. And where's my knife? Gotta do this carefully so I don't poke my paint. And we have 12 colors here and little 4-ounce bottles. We've got some lamp black, raw umber, burnt sienna, ultramarine, cobalt, hooker's green. There's that color again. Okay, I haven't seen that until recently, I don't think. Viridian, crimson, vermilion, yellow ochre, lemon yellow, and titanium white. Let's just kind of pluck one out, take a look at it, give it a poke. So if you've never seen these, the lids, focus, have this pokey thing in the middle, and you just poke it down, and given the color spread and the size and shape of these bottles, I do wonder if this wasn't the same company, manufacturer, that did the Dugato paints, and I really liked those ones. I've done some playing around with those. I think I showed you the little guy that I did with them. Here he is. I think I showed you this, that I did with the Dugato paints. He turned out really nice. Is this, I want to see. So it doesn't tell me if it's matte or gloss is the thing, which is kind of annoying because I don't like gloss paints. I have a feeling if it did come from the same, manufacturer as the Dugato paints, they're probably going to be gloss. And I expect that from a lot of these products. Arteza, which we looked at something from that last week, that is a brand that I know produces their own stuff. They're fairly new. I've actually been offered deals from them before, back when I was just an embroidery channel. And I thought about taking it, but I didn't want to because at that point I was just embroidery and I was like, eh, I don't really do that stuff on this channel. Which, the fact that they are available for this program actually surprised me. But like a lot of the paints that we get, like I wouldn't be surprised if the mica powder that we get, because I got a few of them, I wouldn't be surprised if those are all from the same factory as well. So I think we're going to see a lot of that. The same factory, but different brands. The markers. Every single marker I have got. 1, 2, 3 different packages over the last couple of weeks have all been the same factory, just different labels and different shapes. So yeah, I think we're going to see that a lot. I think that the pencils were probably the same factory as the one I bought before. So I'm not surprised. And honestly, like, if that means that I know I can buy consistently across brands, that's actually a good thing, because that means that I don't have to go, oh no, where's that brand that I really liked? Oh, well, you know, this one's got the same numbers on it. I can use that. So I bet that's what we're going to run into here. Really not surprised at all if that is what happens. The problem with having it in a bag is that it's hard to grab. And now, here we've got something that I think a lot of you are going to be very interested in. We have got a Pauwine embroidery set. Let's take a look here. What have we got? We have got... is that 11 count? That's like 10 or 11 count. That is enormous. Okay, wasn't expecting that. We have got more bamboo hoops. And I think I've said before that I prefer bamboo over the wooden ones. These ones don't seem to fit. Nope, it's not that they don't fit. That one's just really loose. Okay, but we've got some bamboo hoops in a variety of sizes. We have got the... oh, we've got a couple of really nice patterns. Those are actually really cute. So it shows you full stitches, half, quarter, three quarter. That's cool. And then shows you how to use your hoop, how to use your thimble. That's cool. Okay. So then we have this, which is DMC matched. I am going to wager, just by looking at it, this is probably CXC. Yep, that's CXC. I can tell by the way that it feels. CXC is Chinese DMC equivalent, and it's polyester. And then there's Royal Broider, which is also a DMC equivalent that is cotton. They're both pretty decent. I've used them both. And I feel like we're going to get a lot of CXC floss. We've talked about it on the channel before. And then, what have we got here? We have got... a bag I can't seem to get into. Okay, so let's just go through the bag. We've got a pair of snips. I've got so many pairs of snips at this point. I don't even like them, but I've got a bunch. There are these kind of really scary scissors, and I've got a whole bunch of those. I don't like them. Not a fan, but, you know, they're going to give them to me. We have got... okay. Man, they're really making sure you... have some options. So we've got a few bobbins. I can always use more bobbins, that's for sure. They give us two of this style needle threader, which I think we can all agree these ones kind of suck. Oh, that is giving a weird effect on the camera. And then we've got two of these kind. And these are the needle threaders that we are sending out with the Kickstarter, because those are superior needle threaders. Nice, I've got a new seam ripper. Always need one of those. They called it something else in the book, though, but always need more of those. I have got what appear to be some... ooh, those are either 24 or maybe even 22s, so I'm not sure how... oh my god, yeah, that is like a 22. That is an enormous needle, but then again, we've got like 11 count Ada, so... these are probably going to stick around for me to do framing with. I think that's what that will be. Oh, interesting. The lid is threaded, but the thing is not, so it just kind of popped on there. And then we have got, actually, what looks like a very useful thimble. Because my problem with thimbles is always that, well, I can't, you know, feel what I need to feel with the tip of my finger. But then now I can, you know, I'm gonna try that out. I've never actually used a thimble that I like, but I might like this one. So that's kind of cool. But I think that's where I'm going to go ahead and end this one. Lots of really cool stuff. I'm looking forward to seeing what I can do with this kit. Probably not going to do any of the designs with it. I might, I don't know. But yeah, no, I'm really impressed with that embroidery kit. Fairly impressed with the pencil set. What else did we get? The paints, I have a feeling I know how that's going to go. Just a hunch. The wires, a little disappointed that they were labeled wrong. I thought there was going to be a smaller gauge. And the pencil case, I knew as soon as I touched the other one that I wasn't going to like that one. So those ones are going to be interesting, I think, to try to figure out what to do with. But I think the highlight of this one is probably this embroidery kit. You get a lot of floss. I don't remember how many, probably 150. It looks like a lot. And you get a good spread, just about a little bit of every shade, or a few shades of just about every color, it looks like. So yeah, that'll be interesting. Ow, just banged my arm really hard on my table. No, I think the pencil case and the embroidery, or the pencil set and the embroidery set, are going to be the pretty much the standout from today. I think those are both really impressive. I'm really happy with those. So yeah, looking forward to starting to do some work with those. I think they'll be a lot of fun. But I'm gonna go ahead and end it here. Also, I keep forgetting to mention that I am putting affiliate links for everything down in the description below. If you use those links, that really helps me out. It doesn't cost you anything extra, but that will give you a list of everything that you have seen in this video today, and you can go check them out and take a look at them if you want. It's very hot. I want to be done. I want to go hide in the AC, but there's still a few more of these to do. But thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, all that fun stuff. Make sure you turn on notifications if you want to make sure that you see everything. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!